This is Hi Kumar Kurtiwada. In this video, we will learn about basic template driven forms at controller level. In the previous video, we have seen about basic template driven forms at a HTML level where we will not have any relation between the controller and HTML file. So here in this case, we will try to create some variables in our controller level and we will bind them with our ng model and we will create a template driven form by using that particular objects. Let me quickly jump into Visual Studio Code. Here I have created a basic template project by the name Angular Tutorial, and here I'm trying to write a basic HTML form content. Let me write form and let me create an input field with a placeholder username, and let me break it twice and let me use input with a placeholder password, and let me create two more break statements and then button. Let me give type is equal to submit, and also let me give login. Save this, and here let me hit ng serve. This will create a basic form with two fields, username and a password, with one single button called as login. Let me go to the browser output and let me reload this at localhost 4200, which is the default one. Let me zoom it. Yeah, we have created two fields, username and a password, along with the login button. Now, what I want to do is, in the previous video, we have created ng model with the name of the form. But now, in this case, I want to create a ng model with an object which I want to create at a controller level. So let me give login form object is equal to, I want to give a username like empty and password as empty. So by default, login form object values are empty. Let me save this. Let me copy this login form object and let me write ng model. Ng model equal to, and it's model and dot username, and also let me copy this ng model and paste here along with the password, and let me save this. Go to the browser, reload and inspect this. If you inspect, you can see some error, like if ng model is used inside a form tag, either the name attribute must be set or the standalone in ng model options need to be defined. So what we want to do is, just I want to give the name, let me give the name is equal to username. I have explained about this ng model options and the name property usage in my previous video. I'll provide the link in the description. Please watch that video for better understanding. Let me paste here and name as password. So I have given the name as password, and let me hit enter for our better understanding and the clear vision. Yeah, so format and hit enter, save. So go back, and now the errors in the console has been gone. So now what I want to do is, I want to enter the values inside this name and the password. Whenever I click on the submit button, I'll be consoling these two values. Let me go to the TS file and let me create a login submit is my method, and inside this method, just I want to console this values, this dot login form object. Save this and go back, and here we have created a type as submit, and now what I want to do is, I have a inbuilt method called as ng submit. Ng submit is an event which is used inside the form whenever the person clicks on the type as submit button. So let me call this login submit button. Let me copy this and paste here and call this. Save this and go back. So let me reload and let me enter the values, some values, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and hit login. If you see here, we got username and the password. Here in this case, this username and the password are coming from the login form object, but not from the name property. So this is how you can use your forms with ng model from the controller side. So here we are defining a login object, and that login object is binded with our ng model. Whenever I click on the login submit, we are getting these values. And one more thing is, whenever we are having two buttons, let me copy this button and let me create one more button with the type as submit, check submit. So here what I want to define is, whenever you have a button and that button is having a submit and another button with again a submit, then in the both the cases of this form, it will call this login submit. So let me go back to the browser, and here whenever I click enter something, click on login, you can see these values. And also check submit. Let me clear this, check submit. Even that is also calling the same method. So what I want to conclude is, whenever you are using a form, and inside the form if you want to use the buttons, please make sure which has to be submitted and which has to be called ng submit. Whenever you want to call only the ng submit, only that particular button, please define it as a submit button. So I can remove this. Just for the explanation purpose, I have created one more button. So this is how you can use your ng model with controller values, and we can find the values of that particular ng model login form object. So here we are not passing any form element to our controller. Instead, we are creating our own object, and that own object having a default values and are updated whenever it is binded with our ng model. So this is how we can use ng model at a controller level. Hope you guys like this video. If you like my video, please like, share, subscribe to my channel for more updates. Signing off. Thank you.